Hi, in this video, I want to show you the calculation of the code-dependent deflections in SCIA Engineer for concrete structures. My name is Ivan Beleš. This video consists from 3 or 4 parts. In first part, I would like to explain why we do these checks. Then in the second part, I will explain the theory. And in the third and fourth part, I explain the input and the handling of SCIA Engineer, and also together with the interpretation of the results. So first, let me explain what we are doing. We have the limit state calculation. And in the limit state calculation, we have ultimate limit state. This is not a topic of this video. And then we have serviceability limit state. And for concrete structures, the serviceability limit state is defined in the chapter 7.2 in Eurocode AN 1992-1-1. And in 7.2, we have a limitation of the stresses. In the chapter 7.3, we have the limitation of the crack width. And in chapter 7.4, we have the limitation of the deflection. And this is the topic of this video. And in the chapter 7.4, we have 2 parts. We have the part 4, where is described that we have to use the quasi-permanent combination, quasi-statical combination. And with this combination, we have to limit the deflection to 1 to 250. And then in section 5, we have described that after the building of the construction, the deflection should be lower than 1 to 500. After the building, that means we have usually in my model I have permanent loads G0 G1, and then I have serviceability loads Q1 and Q2. And that means from these 2 loads, in my case, the deflection should not increase the 1 to 500 between the supports. How is it calculated? We have cracked concrete, so the stiffness of the concrete is smaller than for non-cracked, and we have to calculate this stiffness. There are 2 calculations in SCIA Engineer for cracked concrete. The one is the so-called PGNL. This is a physical and geometrical nonlinear calculation. This is this full nonlinear calculation with redistribution of the internal forces. This is not what we are doing. We are doing the checks according the code. And in the code, it's described that we have to calculate the stiffness in state 1, which is non-cracked, and we have to calculate the stiffness in full cracked section. And between these 2 states, we have to interpolate. And for the interpolation, there is in SCIA Engineer help this diagram. We have bending moment and we have the strain in the concrete, and we have the behavior of the structure in state 1, and we have the behavior of the structure in state 2. So there is some critical bending moment where the cracks start to develop. And if the load is smaller than this critical bending moment, then we have non-cracked structure. And after them, we have some development of the cracks. until we get full cracked structure. So we have the uncracked structure, and we have the full development of cracks, and we have some area where the checks are spreading, and this is our area where we have to calculate this interpolation. So first we have to decide if our section in 1D or 2D element, a finite element, is cracked or non-cracked. And this is done for the characteristic combination. Then we check the cracks. If it is non-cracked, then we have linear stiffness. If it is cracked, then we have state 2, so cracked structure, and we have to interpolate between non-cracked and cracked structure. In Eurocode, there is a formula 7.19, where we have xi is 1 minus sigma sr divided by sigma s 2 times beta. I forgot. Sigma sr is the tension in steel for full cracked structure, and sigma s is tension in steel for our combination, which we are now calculating. Beta is factor which is 1 for short term loads and 0.5 for long term loads. And this xi coefficient can be used for the calculation of the stiffness. For example, we have the bending stiffness, maybe in y direction, and this will be calculated with this formula, 1 divided by xi divided through AE2. This is the stiffness of full cracked section, plus 1 minus xi divided through AE1 in non-cracked structure. And with this xi help us to interpolate between EI1 and EI2. And so for short-term deflections we use EC is ECM, and for long-term deflections we use EC as ECM divided through 1 plus phi, which is the creep coefficient. Now, very briefly, we know how the stiffness and how the deflections are calculated. Deflections are calculated with the new reduced stiffness. And we have also the loads, the combinations. You have to select some combination for the calculation of the deflection. In SCIA Engineer, you usually select some envelopes where you have more life loads, for example, wind and traffic and life load, and from these combinations a lot of different situations can occur. So this is my plate with a span of 6 meters and 8 meters, and if I look from the top view, I have a plate with line support, 6 meters and 8 meters, and this width is 2 meters. And on this plate, I have 3 or 4 load cases. So first I have the cell fate, which is G0. Then I have G1, which is permanent load. And then I have 2 live loads. The first one is Q1 and the second one is Q2. So if we use some combination, at the moment it's not important if it is quasi permanent or characteristic or some another combination. No, it goes only about the load cases which are included in the combination. So we have the G0 and we have G1. They are every time together because it's permanent load. Then we have Q1 and we have Q2. So I create a small table and we have some combinations which we can get. So we can get a combination only with G, or G with Q1, G with Q2, and G with both of them. So this is CO1, CO2, CO3, and CO4. CO. After this split of the combination of this envelope to linear combinations, SCIA engineer have to calculate short-term deformations, immediate deformation, long-term deformation. So we need some combinations for it. And each of these combinations, I use this one, will be again split to one immediate combination. I write CO immediate. And this C, in this CO immediate, I have only permanent loads and load cases which are defined as long-term loads. You can define it in the characteristics of the load case. There is short, long, medium, long, and only if it's long, this variable load, then it's taken into this immediate combination. So in our case, we have G0 and G1 in this combination. Then the engineer generates a combination for creep. And this is this quasi-permanent combination where we have G0 plus G1 plus, in our case, C2. And this is with Q1 and Q2. In this case, only Q2. Q2. And then we have combination characteristic combination, which is G0 plus G1. Plus, because we have only one group of variable loads, this is a group one, then we have only Q1 and Q2. In other cases, you have another combination, another load cases with C0. You can define if you use for this combination C2 or some different coefficient. This is in the settings in SCIA Engineer. So each of the combinations will be split to these three combinations. So the envelope will be split to linear combinations, and each linear combination will be split to three different types of combinations. How can we perform this check? So first we need some model. This is a very simple model of one slab. I have following load cases. G1 is the self-weight, then G2 is permanent load, then I have Q1 and Q2. So it will be deactivated. I have also results. And now we go to concrete. And in concrete, you find the checks, deflection checks, in reinforcement checks, ultimate limit state, serviceability limit state, code-dependent deformations. First, so, and everything what we are doing is in this menu. If you have already calculated the reinforcement, then it will be used. If you don't have reinforcement, then it will be calculated in this menu. So you need only this one menu for the calculation of 1D and 2D. That means for beams, columns, and also for slabs, walls, and shells. What we have to define? Selection. Which part of the structure do I want to calculate? And this needs some explanation. Because what happened if you select current? If you select all, then it's clear. The full structure will be calculated in state 2. That means in cracked state. If you select current and you have some building with more slabs, for example, there is some wall and so on and a window. If you select only this part of the structure and you define current, then this part of the structure, the selected elements, will be calculated in cracked status, and all other elements this is in state 1, everything. And this, which is selected, is calculated in state 2, in correct state. The calculation is quicker, and also the influence of the another parts, like some balls and so, is not so important. Is there, because the full structure is still calculated, but the deflections are not so high than if you calculate everything in state 2. And mostly it's not necessary. You select a slab and calculate one slab and another slab and so on. It's your decision. But it's possible to calculate in state 2 only a part of the structure. Then we have combinations. You can select here quasi-permanent or characteristic or some another combination. These are combinations which are defined automatically by SCIA Engineer. You can select also different combination, and what you select for the calculation of deflections, this have influence on the calculated results. I will explain it later after we will have results. Then we have reinforcement. We can have required reinforcement, which is simply the area of reinforcement in some section with the influence of the minimal reinforcement, maximal distances and so on. This could be sometimes too low value of the area of the reinforcement, because you get reinforcement only if you have tension in concrete or if you have pressure in concrete and the concrete cannot take these forces, then a new reinforcement is necessary. So you get also areas where you don't have reinforcement, but in the reality you have some basic reinforcement which is going through the full beam or full plate on the bottom, maybe sometimes also on the upper side. So, and also the steps of the reinforcement, so the reinforcement you don't get 5.332 square centimeter per meter. The reinforcement is divided to some areas where you have, for example, basic reinforcement, diameter of 10 millimeter, each 200 millimeters. Then you have some additional layer of reinforcement and next layer. And this one can be defined with provided reinforcement. But this is sometimes also too low value. Sometimes you need much more reinforcement, and then you can combine it with user-defined reinforcement. So you can define your bars or meshes and add it to this reinforcement, or you can say, no, I calculate only with the inputted reinforcement. Sometimes you get structures, maybe they have too high deflections, and you know what was inputted in the structure, which reinforcement do you have there, you have the reinforcement drawings, and you can redraw the reinforcement drawings in SCIA Engineer, draw the meshes and calculate what was in the reality and compare it with the reality. I have done it for the university in Bratislava 1 or 2 years ago, so it works perfectly. So we stay at required reinforcement. I explain it later in the input. And then we have some results. We have values for the results, total deflection, additional, immediate, short creep, explain again. So everything is in this menu. So what I have explained is only the selection to current. I select all and I go to quasi-permanent and with required reinforcement. Start the calculation. It will take 23 seconds. I make a cut and go back after the calculation. I explained the reinforcement. I have used only required reinforcement. If you are not satisfied with this 40 millimeters, you can define your templates for the provided reinforcement. How to do it? You can do it in the reinforcement design, in this design defaults, and then for plates longitudinal, you can select some template. This is for the full structure. Usually you define some another template for base plate, for walls, for slabs. So therefore I go to settings per member, select my plate, and now I can input a template on this plate. template on plate. This is my template. I will create a new one. And in this template, you have two parts. This blue one is the basic reinforcement. The basic reinforcement is everywhere on this one plate. And then you have additional reinforcement, and the additional reinforcement will be defined only if necessary, if the required reinforcement is more than the basic reinforcement. So for the basic reinforcement on the upper side, I will change the distance to 200 millimeters. And for the additional reinforcement, I use list by spacing. That means I have constant diameter and different spacings. For example, 0, 50 millimeters, 100 millimeters, 150, and 200 millimeters. Okay, and then you see the reinforcement. 0, 30 square centimeters, 15, 10, and 7. This is additionally to this 3.9 square centimeters per meter. You can also use by diameter, then you have constant distance and different diameters. So I use the same everywhere, and I can copy Ctrl C and Ctrl V. So I change it to the same 14, Ctrl V, and here also the same 14 and Ctrl V. Okay. This was defined. You can make your own templates. I would say the best way is for different thicknesses, for 20, 30 centimeter and so thick slabs, because you have every time a different maximum reinforcement. Okay, and this will be inputted on my slab. That's all. And now I can calculate the deflections, not with required, I can calculate with provided reinforcement. And to the provided reinforcement, you can also add user-defined reinforcement. The user-defined reinforcement can be defined here in this menu. And then you can define your own reinforcement. You can combine it, but I would not combine maybe the templates with user-defined reinforcement because then SCIA Engineer use the basic reinforcement. Then your user-defined reinforcement, and if there is the, I draw it. If you have, for example, our slab, and in this slab, for example, for the bottom reinforcement, you define some basic reinforcement, and then you will define some mesh here in this area. Then it's added to the basic reinforcement, and then you have some required reinforcement. Maybe it looks so, and maybe it looks so. And in these cases, if the engineer needs something more, then it's used from this additional reinforcement, which was defined in this concrete data. So here, the engineer would add some more reinforcement. If you want use, you can also define in this template only the basic reinforcement. I draw it here, only basic reinforcement. And for the additional reinforcement, you can draw your meshes. And then you have it fully under control if you want to have some specific values. So you can combine everything. The theoretical reinforcement, or use the provided reinforcement, combine it with the user reinforcement, or only the user reinforcement. So we have the provided reinforcement, we have the template, and now I could calculate the deflection with it. Again, few seconds. Okay, it's calculated. It's very short, but we have a lot of combinations to calculate. So we have something about 30 millimeters. Maybe I am still not satisfied. I would like to have only, say, 20 millimeters. So let's say I want to have only basic reinforcement from the template and additional reinforcement defined by me. Sorry, I mix German and English language every time. So my English teacher says I have a terrible German accent. So I go to the template, edit, change the type to fix. Here and also here, and then change it to 0. Okay, so I have only basic reinforcement in my slab, and then I have to add this additional reinforcement, but by me, my values. So I go to reinforcement input 2D, and I would like to input 20 millimeter bars with distance of 15 centimeter on the bottom side, lower side. So look from the top view. The tracking is activated and I start somewhere. So I go to rectangle. With shift you can use the tracking from here, and I say again with shift to here, and again on this side from here to here. This is on the bottom side. If you want to have also some description, then it's here in setup dialog. You can activate the description of these tabs, and then in the part concrete, where is concrete, you can select what you have, how you want to describe it. These labels and names. Mm-hmm. So, and then descriptions, diameter, distance. So you can describe it. Distribution, simple, whatever, however you want. Okay. And then on the top side, upper reinforcement, we have the same. And I define it again with this rectangle from maybe from this point to this point. Okay. Now I have a combination of template and additional reinforcement defined with this in user defined reinforcement. And then I go to provide it with consider user reinforcement and start the calculation again our 20 or 25 seconds. Okay, and after the calculation we see between 18 and 20 millimeters is the deflection. And if you define also the basic reinforcement, then you can change to user reinforcement, and only this inputted reinforcement will be used for the calculation of the stiffness, and with this stiffness for the calculation of the deflection. Okay, that was about the input, and now we have to look on the results. So first the results, you have the standard results. Sometimes for our example would be better to have one line in the result so you can combine it. It's in the result tools, we have section. The drawing of this section will be vertical, okay, for us, and the direction in which we cut the structure is vertical. This is X, Y, and Z. This is a vector from this point to zero, and in this direction, the cut will be moved. I will make some extra video for it. I don't know if I did it maybe already. Okay. We have the cut and we go to the check, and I say I would like to have the standard results and also the section. And then you see both of them. So for me, it's better to see only this one section, the deflections. And extreme is global, mesh would be then for each. If this is too much of the decimal points, I go to results, loads, results, no deformations, length only one decimal point, and we also don't need the units. Where are the units? Section errors, warnings, outputs, I don't know where. Okay, let's see it. So we have the results, and what is it? This is the total reinforcement, but we have a lot of another values. I will explain in one diagram. Let's use our situation. Oh, this is too much. A little bit smaller. Okay. Horizontal. Horizontal, we have deflection. Vertical, we have load or our combination. Let's draw the diagram. If we increase the load, then the deflection will increase linear for the linear in state one deflection for the linear stiffness. But we have also nonlinear stiffness without creeping and nonlinear with creeping. So without creeping, we get, if we don't have cracks, then we have linear stiffness. And after the cracks, of course, we have something like this line. This is short-term deflection. And if we use creeping, then the module of elasticity will be reduced with the factor 1 plus phi, which is the creep factor. And then we will get a little bit more deformation also in non-cracked situation, and a little bit more also if we have cracks. So this is the state 2 with cracks. And what do we have for loads? In this direction, I draw the loads. So we have some G0. This is the self weight. Then we have some, should keep the distance. We have some G1, which is the dead load. These are all loads. And from this load, if we calculate the short term deflection, then we get this immediate. This is delta immediate. This is deflection, which occurs between point zero and after the structure is built. We will need it for this article 7.4.1.5, where is described that after the structure is built, the deflection should not increase 1 to 500. And this is what happened before the structure is built. So we have to reduce the deformation with this explained. Then we have some, this is the immediate combination, which is generated by SCIA Engineer. And then we have some situation, we have inputted in our model, we have used the quasi-permanent combination. So this is the quasi-statical or quasi-permanent combination, where we have the permanent loads, and plus we have the psi 2 times q1 and psi 2 times q2, or maybe both together, I don't know. This will be calculated for all possible combinations. And for this combination, we get the short term deflection. This is delta short. And we get also the deflection, which is only from creeping. This is delta creep. And both together, I draw it here, is delta tot. Delta tot is delta short plus delta creep. And if we need this one to, and this should be lower than 1 to 250. And we have in this another article, this 1 to 500, and this is this ed. Delta ed is delta tot minus delta immediate. And this should be lower than 1 to 500. This is in the situation if we use the quasi-permanent combination for the calculation. But maybe you have a situation, this is if you do the checks according the Eurocode. But sometimes there are also different situations which are not covered by Eurocode. Maybe you have mobile walls. And if you have a mobile wall, then the wall is not reading the Eurocode. And if you, after 5 years, for example, where you have the long-term deformations already built, and then you get full load, then you get more deformation than this which is asked by Eurocode. And from mobile loads, mobile walls, you get immobile walls. So, and they cannot move, and you have to do something. So, and if you want to calculate it, then you use for the calculation in SCIA Engineer here, not the quasi-permanent, you can use another combination. For example, characteristic combination, because this is the full load, which we can get. And in this situation, we have again our load, we have our deflection, we have our linear deflection, we have our short-term deflection, and we have our long-term deflection with creeping. And then we have again our immediate combination. In immediate combination we have our G0, then we have there our G, nicht Q, G1. Then we have again SCIA Engineer also, if you say you want to calculate for the characteristic combination, SCIA Engineer creates this quasi-permanent or quasi-statical combination, which is the Q1 times Psi2. If you don't want to use this Psi2, maybe you have another times. I calculated again for the university in Bratislava situation where they had from the geometers the deflections after each month. So we could calculate it exactly and I could adapt these Psi factors. Then you have to go to the concrete settings, and in concrete settings, SLS, you have to look internal forces, punching, stress, crack, deflections. Then you can say, you can increase the reinforcement by factor if you want. And then you have this factor, which is used for the calculation of the quasi-permanent combination. You can use Psi2 or you can define your own factor. Go back to our explanation. So we have this with Psi2 and we have Q2 time Psi2 load. And then until we get the full load, we have also some remaining Q1 times 1 minus C2, I hope it's correctly. But then totally you have characteristics. You have here G0 plus G1 plus Q1 plus Q2. This is everything together. So, and then we have again our immediate, delta immediate, delta immediate, okay. Then we have the short term, which is now calculated from this characteristic. This is delta short. The quasi-permanent part of the this long-term part of the deflection, which is created by this creep coefficient, is here from quasi-permanent combination. This is delta creep. And this delta creep will not increase. This is calculated from this combination. So delta creep will simply add it to the delta short. And delta short, as explained before, is delta tot. Delta tot is delta short plus delta creep. And then we need again the additional deformation, which is after delta immediate, and this is delta additional is delta dot minus delta immediate. And this is this 1 to 500, and this is the total deflection if you want to be sure that your mobile walls will not be corrupted. And you can evaluate everything which you want. You can look on this delta immediate. This is only from permanent loads. In my situation, it's only permanent load. Then you have this delta short. Delta short is for my quasi-permanent combination, the short-term deformation. Then I have only from creep. So short is 10, creep is 8. So we have something about 18 millimeters total. 18 millimeters, and immediate was 6. So we have 12 millimeter, which is after the structure is built. And this is add. And this limit is only the limit which you can define in your settings, 5 centimeter, and then you see a constant value. And linear is linear without influence of concrete. This is only if you want to compare how much is the deformation increased. So that's everything in the explanation. If you want to see it, where is it in SCIA Engineer in the help, then you can go to support. You go to SCIA.net and then go to, I should not click on the pictures. You go to support, help portal, or write simply in Google SCIA help, then you go directly to SCIA help, online help. And then you see the design of concrete members according Eurocode. And then you go to concrete code-dependent deformations, deflections, then you see all the explanation of the input and also the theoretical background of the with the calculation of the stiffness. So I hope you are satisfied with this video. Maybe you look on next videos. Thank you very much.